Hi everyone, it's Emmett from PyMy Life Up. In this video, we will be showing you how to set up PyHole using Docker. PyHole is a network-wide ad blocker that works by acting as your DNS server. As this will be acting as your DNS server, you will need to set a static IP address for your device. The best way to achieve this is to use DHCP reservation on your router. To begin setting up this software, you'll want to open the terminal on your Linux device. In our case, we can just press Ctrl+Alt+T to quickly bring up the terminal. For the first part of this guide, we'll be showing you how to install Docker. If you already have Docker installed, you can skip ahead. Your first step is to update the package list by typing in sudo apt update, pressing enter. You may be prompted to enter the password for your sudo user to continue. With the package list now updated, we can upgrade any out-of-date packages by typing in sudo apt upgrade hyphen y. Our next step is to ensure curl is installed to your system by typing sudo apt install curl. We will be using curl to execute the Docker install script. This makes installing Docker significantly easier and helps ensure we have the latest version. To run this install script, type in curl space hyphen S capital L space https://get.docker.com/pipe symbol /sh. This script will use the official Docker repository to install the latest available version. This will help ensure that you have a smoother experience later when setting up PyHole using Docker. With Docker now installed, our next step is to add our current user to the Docker group. This will allow us to control Docker without having to use sudo and elevating to the super user. To add your current user to this group, type in sudo usermod -a capital G docker $user, all in uppercase. The dollar sign helps us reference an environment variable that is automatically filled in with your current user's username. To ensure the entire operating system is aware of your user change, restart your system by typing sudo /reboot. With your Linux device now restarted, you can begin setting up PyHole itself using Docker. To make this easy, you'll be using a Docker Compose file. This allows you to better set environment variables and other things such as attached volumes. Let's start this process by making a directory where we'll keep the Compose file. To do this, type in sudo mkdir /opt/stacks/pyhole and then press enter. Now change into this new directory by typing in cd /opt/stacks/pyhole. We can now begin to write the compose file that will set up and manage PyHole using Docker on our system. To begin writing this file, type in sudo /nano/compose.yaml. We need to start off this file by defining a new list of services by typing in services followed by a colon symbol. We can then define our PyHole service by typing in PyHole followed by a colon. It's important to note here that the spacing is incredibly important within this file. Each new list needs to be within its own indentation, so pay attention to that you have set the right amount of spacing for each list as we have done here. Next, we'll give this container a name by typing container underline name colon followed by the name PyHole. Up next, we need to define the image that it should use for this container. To do this, type in image colon space PyHole /PyHole:latest. This tells Docker to download the PyHole container image that has been marked as the latest from the PyHole repository. Next, we need to specify a new list where we'll define each of the ports we want open from this container. To start this new list, type in ports followed by the colon symbol. Now we can set our first port by typing in "-53:53/TCP". Port 53 is important as it is what is used by the DNS protocol. Now type the same line out again, but this time type in UDP instead of TCP. The next port we want to make available from our container is port 67. To do this, type in "-67:67/UDP" and then finish it with a double quote. This port is used for the DHCP functionality built within PyHole. Next, type in "-80:80" /TCP, double quote. Opening up this port allows us to access Pi-hole's web interface. Next, we need to define some environment variables that help control the way Pi-hole works. Start this section by typing in environment, followed by the colon symbol. The first environment variable we set will be controlling the time zone that Pi-hole uses. To do this, type in TZ colon space double quote, followed by your TZ identifier. And finally, a double quote again. If you don't know your TZ identifier for where you live, we will have a link below to show you where to find this. The next environment variable we're setting is what controls the web password for the Pi-hole interface. To set this, type in web password colon space double quote followed by your password and then ending it with a double quote. Ensure you set something secure for this password, as this user will be able to control the way your DNS server operates. Our next step is to set up some volumes so that the data within our Docker container will persist between restarts. Start this section by typing in volumes followed by a colon symbol. This first volume can be defined by typing in dash space single quote dot slash etc dash pi-hole colon symbol slash etc slash pi-hole followed by a single quote. This makes Pi-hole's configuration files and metadata persist between each restart. We need to define one more volume by typing dash space single quote dot slash etc hyphen dnsmasq dot d colon symbol slash etc slash dnsmasq dot d single quote. This volume is used to ensure that Pi-hole's DNS settings are persistent between each reboot. Next, we need to ensure that this Docker container has some additional capabilities not typically added by Docker. To define these, type in cap underline add followed by the colon symbol. Underneath this section, you'll want to type in dash space net underline admin, all in uppercase. This capability will allow our Pi-hole container to control certain aspects of the Linux networking system. Next, on a new line, type in restart colon unless hyphen stopped. This ensures that Docker will automatically restart Pi-hole if it ever crashes. Now save and quit by pressing Ctrl plus X followed by Y and then Enter. If you're running Ubuntu or Fedora, there's some additional changes we will need to make to your system. If you aren't using these operating systems, then please skip this section. On Ubuntu and Fedora, you will need to disable the DNS stub listener that is built into the systemd results service. Begin editing the configuration for this service by typing in sudo nano slash etc slash systemnd slash resolved.com. Within this file, you'll want to navigate down until you see the DNS stub listener equals yes option. Once found, you'll want to delete the hashtag in front of it and then change the word yes to no. Once you have made this change, you can save and quit by pressing Ctrl plus X, then Y, and then Enter. With this change made, we will need to remove the existing resolve.com file by typing sudo space rm slash etc slash resolve.com. With this file removed, we now need to create a symbolic link in its place to point to a different location. To do this, type in sudo space ln space dash s space slash run slash systemd slash resolve.com space slash etc slash resolve.com. Pay attention to how we've written resolve here, as it's written different ways twice. As we have made several changes to the resolve service, we now need to restart it by typing in sudo systemctl space restart space systemd hyphen resolved. If you see a message about changes happening to your system, you'll need to also restart the systemctl daemon. You can do this by typing in sudo systemctl daemon hyphen reload and then pressing enter. We can now bring up the Pi-hole service by typing in docker space compose space up space hyphen d. The use of the d option basically tells Docker to detach from the current session and run in the background. Docker will now automatically pull the Pi-hole image and start it on your system. With Pi-hole now running, all you need to do is point your device's DNS server to your Linux device running Pi-hole. Once you have your device pointed to your Pi-hole server, you'll immediately begin to block any requests that go to a known domain that serves ads. If you have forgotten what your IP address is, you can type in hostname space dash capital I and hitting enter. In our case, you can see that our local IP address is 192.168.0.47. To control Pi-hole and how it works, you'll want to access its web interface. To this, you'll need the IP address we just grabbed and your favorite web browser. Now in this web browser, you'll want to go to http://, followed by your IP address, /admin. You'll now be greeted by the login page for Pi-hole. On this page, you'll want to use the web password that you specified within the Docker Compose file earlier. Once you have typed it in, just simply click the login button to access the Pi-hole web interface. At this point, you have now successfully gotten Pi-hole running using a Docker container. If you like this guide, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe. Until next time, have a good one.